Hey YouTubers, it's Christine from Christine Peace, and I would like to comment on an article that was written in, and let me bring up my Word document because I have scripted this one. I know I normally don't do that, but I really want to make sure that my point gets across and that I don't miss anything. Okay, this article was called Who's the Daddy? And it was by a woman named Melanie, and I'm going to say her last name wrong, MacDon. Whatever, aka Feminist 66, and it was in the spectator.co.uk, which I'll provide a link to in the crotch bar. So let's begin with my notes or ideas or thoughts on her article. It's an article that can be best described as an affront to the honest and straightforward feminist movement. It smacks in the face of honesty and doing the right thing. Feminist 66 puts forward the idea that DNA testing for parentage is anti-feminist, unbalancing the power between the sexes, even in a society where a woman is economically able to provide for that child. She also states that she sees how the male population would welcome the end to an old-fashioned scenario whereby they find themselves held to account for the parenting of a child born to girls with whom they had just happened to have sex with. Unquote. Even as a self-proclaimed feminist, I'm always critical of other women of this world that use the title as well. Feminism to me is a balance and equality between the sexes, and Feminist 66 is trying to keep it out of balance. An outdated and ineffective method of not only naming a father, but subjecting that father to support some other man's child. One of her excuses for not allowing DNA testing is the child and family will wrongly suffer. Feminist 66 even goes so far as to say that, quote, God knows the cost and misery and recrimination and guilt, end quote. Well, Feminist 66, I don't know this God you speak, but I'm sure that the individual male that pays with his money and feelings knows the pain from living a lie and staying in a marriage that is obviously broken. Not only does the male suffer, but the child will be denied the right to know his or her real father. The loss of power that a woman will have when denied the ability to pick and choose is not, in fact, a loss of a real or justified power. Do not forget that women still have the power to find the right man, the biological father, whom has the legal and moral obligation towards the child. Yes, at one time in our history, women had to find a male most capable of supporting her and the child because women didn't have rights. We didn't have the right to have a job and make money. We have moved forward. Why stop now? Why stop because it's inconvenient or uncomfortable towards us? It's the right thing to do. Remember, at one time, men were allowed to beat their wives. No, I'm not saying that all men beat their wives or are wife beaters. I know that even if it were legal still, a man with integrity wouldn't beat an animal, let alone a woman he married. What I'm trying to say is people have moved on and past mistakes are righted in a good world. Feminist 66, you can see when men might be happy with the end of an outdated father naming process. Well, I'll take this one step further. I can see how human beings, regardless of their sex, would welcome the truth. Feminist 66, your article can only do harm to the feminist movement. Stop dragging the title of feminist through the dirt. I've fought long and hard for my right to choose in this world, even the right to choose poorly. If I'd ever became pregnant in my life and then decided to take that pregnancy to term, I would have needed to live with my choice, even when it might have been a tough one. Stop punishing men. Equality can and will come from the promotion of women in the world, which is easily done without the tearing down of men. So that's the end of my comments on her article. Thank you for listening, and as always, peace.